how long would it take us to go to Ceres? Ceres is the closest dwarf planet to Earth. However, it is much further away than you imagine. To the date of creation of this video, Ceres has only been visited by one spacecraft in all of history, and it took almost 10 years to get there. But why did it take us so long to send a spacecraft to this dwarf planet? Considering the advantages that have been made in space travel technology, how long would it take us to get to Ceres today? Come with us to find out. Dawn Mission. The only space mission that has visited the dwarf planet Ceres was the space exploration probe launched by NASA called Dawn, which had its primary objective to examine and study the physical characteristics of Ceres, as well as those of the asteroid Vesta. This spacecraft was launched on September 27, 2007, and reached the dwarf planet Ceres in 2015. That is, it took 8 long years to reach its final goal. But why did it take so long to arrive? Let's consider that in 2011, NASA launched the rover Curiosity, and a year later it would reach Mars safely. Mars is located on average about 140 million miles from Earth, while Ceres is located on average 257.2 million miles from Earth. That is, the distance between Earth and Ceres is approximately twice that between Earth and Mars. Logic tells us that a mission to Ceres should take twice as long as a mission to Mars. However, the rover Curiosity took only 1 year to reach Mars, while the Dawn mission took almost a decade to reach Ceres. Why does this enormous time difference occur? Visiting small bodies is very difficult. Contrary to logic, small bodies in the solar system, such as comets or asteroids, are challenging for spacecraft to visit, mainly because they have a feeble gravitational force of attraction, so they do not attract spacecraft with sufficient force. Therefore, the exploration probes must perform complicated maneuvers that can easily divert them if they incorrectly calculate during the flyby. We must consider the space exploration probes that visit distant bodies like Ceres are not manipulated in real time by people on Earth, but they manage themselves with digital control and artificial intelligence that directs them automatically. Why is this done? The reason why engineers at NASA and other space agencies decide to have artificial intelligence control the ship instead of people on Earth is distance. Let us remember that Ceres orbits between Mars and Jupiter at an average distance of 257.2 million miles from Earth. This is almost double the distance between Earth and Mars, meaning that the signals we send from Earth take almost 23 minutes to reach Ceres. Can you imagine that? Consider that this is only the time it takes for the signal to reach Ceres. That is, if we also consider the return time of the signal, it adds up to 46 minutes. 46 minutes. That is the time that engineers here on Earth must wait each time they send a message to a spacecraft that is on Ceres. For example, if we send a message to the Dawn probe at 1 o'clock in the afternoon, that signal will arrive at Ceres at 1:23. Then the probe will reply to the message and send it to Earth, but this message will take another 23 minutes to reach Earth. Finally, the reply message will arrive at 1:46. Until that moment, we will be able to know if the first message was received correctly, and we will be able to reply. A delay of 46 minutes between each message, and you thought your internet was slow. As you can imagine, this way of communicating with very distant exploration probes takes too much time. It's not a job suitable for impatient people. If a probe that is so far away had an emergency arise or had to perform an evasion maneuver to avoid an asteroid, it could not depend on a human on Earth giving it instructions to perform that maneuver, since when the evasion order reaches the spacecraft, it will have already collided with the asteroid, since the message will not have arrived instantly, but with a delay of 46 minutes. That is why these types of decisions must be made by the probe autonomously by an AI that tells the ship what to do. Because of this, space exploration ships and probes that are sent to very distant places, such as the outer planets or dwarf planets like Ceres, must be completely autonomous and make decisions independently. This becomes much more important when we talk about the duration of the Dawn mission. A very long trip. The trip to Ceres was not easy. Being more than 250 million miles away, the Brob had to use various maneuvers to reduce the arrival time, which was programmed for the spacecraft to do, automatically and without human intervention. After launch, the spacecraft performed an initial ignition of its ion thruster for 11 interrupted days. From here, the Dawn spacecraft entered the crew's propulsion stage on December 17, 2007. The cruise stage of a spacecraft is a specific phase of a space mission, in which the spacecraft is en route to its final destination, but has not yet reached its objective. During this stage, the spacecraft has already passed the launch and separation stage from the launch pad and has entirely left the Earth's orbit. The cruise stage is an integral part of an interplanetary mission in which the spacecraft heads towards another planet or celestial body. In the cruise stage, the spacecraft is usually in a stable space flight state, often on a transfer trajectory between planets, also known as a Hohmann transfer. Hohmann transfer. Hohmann transfer, also known as Hohmann orbit, is a fundamental concept in orbital mechanics used in space navigation to move a spacecraft from one orbit to another around a celestial body, such as a planet or a moon, so it is efficient in fuel consumption. Hohmann transfer is based on the principle that elliptical orbits around a central body, such as the Sun or a planet, are more energy efficient than straight trajectories in space regarding fuel savings. To move a spacecraft from one orbit to another, this specific transfer is used, which involves two engine ignition maneuvers. The first is to increase the speed of the spacecraft and leave the orbit in which it is located. In the case of the Dawn spacecraft, this occurs when the spacecraft turns on its engines at full power at the perigee of its current orbit to take advantage of the thrust provided by gravity and thus leave Earth's orbit. The other moment occurs when the spaceship slows down as it reaches the aphelion of its new orbit. In astronomy, aphelion and perigee are two terms used in orbital mechanics to describe specific points in the orbit of a celestial body, such as a spacecraft around a central body, such as a planet, star, or satellite. Aphelion is the farthest point in a body's orbit around its central body, and perigee is the closest point in its orbit to its central body. The result is that the spacecraft moves from an initial elliptical orbit to a final elliptical orbit around the same central body, which in this case is the Sun. This maneuver is especially useful in interplanetary space missions, where it is used to transfer a spacecraft from an Earth orbit to an orbit that will take it to another planet. In the case of the Dawn mission, it was used to transfer the spacecraft from Earth orbit to Mars orbit and later to the asteroid belt orbit, the place where Ceres is located. Before moving on, be sure to like or dislike the video so that we can improve them for you, the viewer. Plus, don't forget to subscribe to our channel by making sure to hit the notification bell so you don't miss any of our daily videos. Why did it take so long? The main reason why the Dawn mission took almost a decade, while other space missions like the rover Curiosity took only a year to reach Mars, is due to a single factor, and that factor was the objective of the mission. Although on average Ceres is almost twice as far from Earth as Mars, remember that planets and dwarf planets orbit the Sun at different distances. The farther away the orbit, the longer it takes them to make a complete revolution around the Sun. And as a spacecraft moves away from the Sun, it requires more fuel to accelerate and adjust its trajectory. On October 31, 2008, the Dawn mission completed the first propulsion stage for the journey to Mars, where it performed a flyby of the red planet to take advantage of gravitational assistance. During this phase of the first interplanetary cruise, Dawn spent 270 days with its thrusters fired and thus managed to leave Martian orbit to head towards Ceres. That is, just like the rover Curiosity's Dawn mission, it also took just 1 year to get from Earth to Mars. Dawn's space exploration probe took the other 7 years to travel the distance between Mars and Ceres? The answer is no. The reason why Dawn took so long to get from Mars to Ceres is because it first had a mission to study the asteroid Vesta, which took several years. Once Dawn finished flying over Vesta, it continued its journey to Ceres, which only took 3 years. Does that mean that if Dawn had a fixed trajectory heading to Ceres without any stops, it would have arrived in only 4 years instead of 8? The answer is probably yes, but it is not sure, since to achieve this, you would need a different type of propulsion. The ion engine, the most efficient of all. The Dawn mission was the first to use ion propulsion, considered the most advanced and efficient space propulsion system. Ion propulsion is a space propulsion system that uses electrically charged ions to generate a high-speed jet. Here's how it works. In an ionization chamber, ions are generated and ejected at high speed using electricity, creating a smooth, continuous pulse that propels the spacecraft. This propulsion system is crucial because it is very efficient and can accelerate the ship to high speeds with little fuel. In this way, spacecraft can acquire very high speeds continuously for long periods, and thus reach distant planets or explore deep space. However, ion propulsion has one major flaw, so it would not be used for manned voyages to distant worlds like Ceres. Ion propulsion is efficient for long-duration missions, as it can provide constant thrust for a long time. Still, it is not capable of providing great acceleration in a short time as chemical fuel rockets do. That is, ion propulsion can propel a spacecraft for several years, but it's not capable of accelerating to high speeds in a short time. So using an ion engine would take us several years to reach Ceres. But if we use chemical engines, it would take less time. The problem with chemical fuel is that it is consumed quickly and takes up a lot of space. Still, if we manage to create a manned interplanetary spacecraft with this type of fuel, it is possible that the travel time between Earth and Ceres would be reduced by half or even less. Unfortunately for now, we do not have a spacecraft with that characteristic. So for the moment, we only have to settle for ion propulsion technology to reach Ceres. But there's no need to get depressed. Even with this technology, we can reach worlds as far away as the dwarf planet Ceres in less than a decade, which is already a reasonable achievement for modern technology. Do you think in the near future we will be able to develop another type of technology allowing us to travel from Earth to the dwarf planet Ceres in less than 4 years? Let us know your opinion in the comments.